Good morning, everyone. I am here to talk about something very serious. And that being trolls. I'm here to talk about the trolls for a very good reason. For you trolls, you might not realize this, but despite what you guys have been doing to me, I've been studying you the whole time. The whole time you guys have been fucking with me, I've been studying you. And a lot of you guys have criminalistic acts. For those of you that don't know how these trolls in particular operate, I'll be posting a link in the comments where you guys can find out more about how these trolls operate. I received this article like about, I'd say, a little under a week and a half ago. And I really started studying. I started studying how they move and how they operate. The trolls feed off of fear. That is their essential goal, is to kill by way of making you seem like you're insane or they try to overpower you by brute force. The trolls I'm dealing with are a combination of intelligence and brute force. You see, these trolls that you see on the internet, if you guys have ever heard of gang stalking, that's literally gang stalking. If you guys have ever heard that term, you guys will understand what I'm getting at. If you guys haven't heard of it, imagine somebody stalking you, but they're not there to do harm to you. They're there to psychologically break you down, make you seem like you're crazy, like you're insane, to the point to where almost no one, including the police, will believe you. Essentially turning the police and everyone you know against you. And that's what these trolls have been trying to do to me. They want to make me look crazy. And essentially they want to kill me and my family mentally. These people are very evil people. Because the way these people think isn't normal. They start off with little things like little snarky comments here and there. And from there they slowly develop into the phase of taking your stuff. Like with me. They took videos of mine, reposted them, and got my channels on YouTube shut down so that I could not lay claim to what is rightfully mine. Or they did another one where they would sneakily go in, steal my music, and release it as their own, knowing that those songs that they stole were mine. And they do this as a way to get your attention. They do it as a way to psychologically be like, oh, I have something of yours. You're not going to be able to get it back. If you want it, come get it. These people are very evil people. And I'm not just saying that. These people are they're not right in the head. These people will use any means at all to get their desired result. Whether that be threatening family, whether that be doing to you like they did with Chris Chan. And if you don't know the Chris Chan situation, he was a mentally handicapped man that they manipulated and basically made him rape his own grandmother, which landed him in prison. And the people that are doing this shit are getting away with this. They'll use tactics like that, or like what they did with me. They tried to set me up to make me look like a pedophile, just so that they could talk shit on me and nobody would really talk to me as a result. These are the kind of tactics that these people use. Not just on me, but on any victim that they come across. Anybody that they see as lesser than they are, or anybody that they see as a target, they will do anything they can to mentally break down that person and destroy them. Which is very scary. And these people, they have no... These people, they have no morals. These people are very sick individuals and they do not care if they break the law. They do not care because in their eyes, in their mind, the law doesn't apply to them. In their mind, they're untouchable. In their heads, they think, oh, I can do this and get away with it. Oh, I can set this person up to look like this and everything will be all good. But it's not all good. Because of people like these guys, there are so many people out there that end up taking their lives every day as a result. There has been a lot of suicide because of people like these. And I think it's time we put it to a stop. But these people, they are very, very evil. They want to use people for their own self-gain. Like with me. In the past 5 years, and I am not exaggerating what I'm about to say by any stretch of the word, I am being 110% honest with you guys. I have done the math many, many, many times over. I've gone over it with friends of mine that actually majored in math in college. And I have sat down with friends that have majored in business that know what's going on. And over the past 5 years, because of these trolls, I've lost close to up over $1 million in ad revenue on YouTube alone. Because of these people, I've lost out on millions of dollars just in ad revenue on YouTube alone. And that's money that could have helped my family. That's money that I could have used to help friends like my boy Matt here in the comments. And I do apologize, Matt, for not seeing your comment, dude. But yes, my mom is doing good. She's doing good. She may be coming on today. I don't know. I'm not sure on that, but I'll get back to you on that. But Because of these people, I've lost out on hundreds and thousands of dollars in ad revenue. And it's sad. No one deserves to have their life ruined because of some selfish fucking prick on the internet who thinks that he's better than everyone. Like, these people have gotten major big time people to attack me. People such as Steve Wilkos from, you know, the big bodyguard from Jerry Springer who now has his own show. Yeah. These people have gotten Steve Wilkos to go after me. These people have gotten Shaggy Tudo from the highly world-renowned underground rap group Insane Clown Posse, or ICP for short. These people have gotten major rapper Danny Brown to come after me. I have been, how do you call it, basically shunned from major music artist Ryan Upchurch's Discord group when I have been a very big supporter since day one. I've lost a lot of friends. I am not able to get a normal, regular 9-to-5 job because of the rumors that these people have spread about me. There's a lot of things that I cannot do at this point in time because of these people. And let me tell you, I never asked to be trolled. When I signed up to do music, that's what I signed up for, to do music. I never signed up to be trolled. I never signed up to have my life ruined. If anything, I signed up to help people. I signed up to take pictures with fans out in public and at Walmarts and wherever else. I signed up to do shows. I signed up to have a good time. I didn't sign up to be fucking trolled. Like, this way that I'm being forced to live, this is not living. I am not living right now. 5-6 years ago, I was living. I was booking shows whenever I could. I was doing shows at friends' houses. I was doing, you know, birthday parties here and there. I was booking shows downtown, trying to get a show. That's living. This being stuck inside my own home with nowhere to go, nothing to do, that ain't living. This is not living. And what's sad is the police blow this off as, oh, it's nothing. But it actually is. These people are the true definition of what a psychopath really is. And I know I'm not the only one that suffers from it. There are hundreds and thousands of people out there every day that suffer from the same thing that I suffer from being trolled, being attacked. And I know a lot of people think like, oh, you just get off the internet and just ignore it. Well, I'm sorry to say, but it does not work like that. It does not work like that. You can't just up and walk away from these people. Because when they victimize you, they will go after you. They will go after your family. They will go after your real life, your job, your work, your home. They will call the police to your house and make up lies and SWAT you. To the point to where they did with me, where I almost got killed by the police force from them SWATting me about a month and a half ago. These people don't need to be on the internet. These people, they are seriously sick. And I'm not just speaking for myself. I am speaking for everyone out there who has been victimized by trolls. For everybody out there that has been a victim of gang stalking. For anybody out there that has been a victim of some sort of bullying on the internet of any kind. This kind of crap that these people do is not okay. Matter of fact, let me pull up the article here and I can tell you. Did you know that alone there are over 132 different types of internet trolls? Like this guy right here. This John M. Brooks. This right here is a classic internet troll. He is attacking me right here. He is attacking me in the comments. This right here is your basic troll. They do snarky comments to get you mad. And this right here I didn't know that, but she's doing good. But that being said, people, we need to start being more aware of the internet. If you have kids on the internet, talk to your kids. And I mean, talk to them. Make sure that they are not going through what I have been put through. Make sure they are not going through what I have gone through for the last 5 years. Because the last 5 years of my life have practically changed my life for the rest of my life. I can no longer go out and get a regular job like I wanted to initially. I always now have to carry some form of protection on me at all times when I shouldn't have to do so. I now have to constantly change my passwords every other day as a result. I have to literally keep everything I do in secret. When I shouldn't have to do that. Everything I do now music-wise, I am forced to keep a secret even from my most hardcore fans that actually enjoy what I do. I have to hide release dates. Stuff that I want to be able to announce. Stuff that I want to be able to be proud to say, hey, this is dropping on this day or this is dropping on that day. I now have to keep everything under wraps. I now have to literally go zero dark, silent, and release my stuff in silent instead of promoting it and being like, hey guys, I have some new music dropping, yada yada yada. I now have to do all that shit in secret because these people will get hackers to fuck with your shit. They will. If you guys are a fellow YouTuber like myself, some of you guys may have run into this problem. And if you have not run into this problem, I hope and pray to God you never have to run into this problem. These people will hack into your Google account, and they, if you have somebody banned that they like that you don't like, they will go in and they will take over your account and they will unban them. They will make it look like you're doing stuff that you are not doing. They will even go as far as to use your image and your likeness against your will and make profit off of it. No matter what, they will find a way to make profit off of you. This is how sick and evil these people actually are. These are the kinds of sick individuals that I have dealt with for the last 5 years. I am a musician. I am a music artist. And I am also an artist of the old school kind. Like, you know, doing artwork and doing digital art and stuff like that. That is what I am. I am not going to stand for being a victim of a troll anymore. I'm not. And another thing to look out for is when you confront, like if you have the balls enough to confront these people, just be warned, just a fair warning, that if you start to state real facts that can put a damper on what they want to do, they will meet you on panel. Like if you go on a panel and you confront them, they will mute you if you say something that they do not like or that they feel is a threat to their motive or a threat to their narrative or storyline that they have made up for you. If they do not like what you say, they will mute you. Trust me, there's been plenty of times where I have spoken facts upon facts to these people, and these people have muted me time and time again. Because I spoke the truth about how these people really are, about how they operate, about what their motives are and why they're doing it. To them, it's all a game. Even if they get real lives involved and they hurt people, they don't care. They do not care about human life. These people do not care about human life. These people, they are out for themselves. And it's honestly sickening. And it's very disturbing. And it's not okay. The kind of crap that these trolls pull, it needs to be stopped and it needs to be taken seriously. So if any of you see any kind of trolling of any kind going on, any kind of bullying, take it seriously. Don't just sit there and brush it off as, you know, oh, it's just somebody on the internet being a bully. No, take it seriously. If you have family and you have friends, take it seriously, especially if you have kids, because these people, they will go after people of children's ages. There was a little kid not too long ago that was part of this community on YouTube that was all about Legos, and it was known as, they were known as the Lego community. There was a whole group of, you know, people that this boy's family was very involved with. They were very nice people. And he was a good kid. He was very smart, did very well in school from what I've seen. And unfortunately, his family witnessed him taking his own life as a result of being trolled and gang stalked on the internet. And I am not afraid to admit it, but because of these gang stalkers and these harassers, I'm a survivor of suicide twice over. In the last 2 to 3 years, I had attempted to take my own life twice in a row because of these evil people. But it was on the second attempt that I realized, after I had failed, it made me realize I don't need to be doing this. If anything, I need to stand up and say something for people like myself. People that get bullied every day by these people. People that get harassed and gang stalked every day. And make no mistake, when it comes to these trolls, they will use every trick in the book. They will go the legal route. They will go the illegal route. They do not care. They will use whatever they have to do and manipulate whatever system they have to manipulate in order to achieve their goal. Whatever that goal may be, they do not care. They will take legal action. They will make themselves look like the victim to the fullest extent. They do not care. They give no fucks. Because, honestly, bro, I honestly don't know why they go after me specifically. But from what I can gather, and I know it sounds dumb, but it partly has to do with how I look. Because I've always been that weird looking kid. Always. But outside of that, my talent. They don't want to see somebody like me succeed. Because see, when they see me, they see somebody that's weak. They see somebody that doesn't belong in the music industry. They don't see somebody that, hey, this dude actually has some banger ass artwork. This dude actually has good songs that speak on real shit. They want to use me as a cash cow, essentially. That's why they go after me, because they see what I am capable of doing, and they want all that money for themselves. And you can fact check me on this. There are thousands of channels on YouTube that have made some serious fucking money off of my face, my image, my story, hell, even my videos that other people have stolen and restreamed. They see me as a way to make money. To them, I'm a cash cow. To them, I am like that thing that they can make money off of. They don't have the time or the want to be original as a content creator, so they come after unsuspecting people like me that do have original work, and they do what they do to make money, which is sickening. Here's the thing. Like I said, Matt, it doesn't matter if you stop responding or not. If you stop responding one way, they will attack your real life. Trust me, I've gone down that road of, you know, not responding. And that's when they attacked my real life. That's when they went after my biological father, got him fired from his job. They got a friend of mine fired from his job. And that's when they started taking action of swatting my house, sending a dead baby pig still in the fetal sack of its mother. They literally sent literal dog shit mixed with hay to my house. These people have sent and done the most sickening things in real life. So essentially there is no ignoring it. It cannot be ignored. Because if they don't attack you one way, they will attack you another. Over and over and over again. And they will make it to where the police don't want anything to do with you, just like they did with me. Because of these people, the police don't believe a word I say. They don't think that any of this is real. They think that I am mentally disturbed. That it's all in my head. But it's not in my head. This is all real shit. And I'm not the only one. There are hundreds of people out there that get victimized every day by people like this. And it's truthfully sad. It truly is sad to see, you know, good people that don't do any kind of harm to anyone being attacked. Being gone after, having their real lives put in danger. Like I said, as much as I wish I could say that ignoring it would help, you're talking to somebody that's lived through it. You're talking to somebody that has gone through this on the fullest level. There is no ignoring it. Because as I said, if they don't get you one way on the internet, they will attack your real life. They will threaten your real life. However that may be, they will do that. Because to the cops, internet stuff does not matter to them. This is how the cops think. Oh, it's on the internet. Get off the internet. Oh, you're dealing with this on YouTube? Get off the internet. It'll solve everything. No, it won't. It will not solve everything. Yeah, it may stop the commenting and you don't have to see it, but that doesn't mean that it's any less there. That doesn't mean that it's there any less. Like, this is a real situation. That one, I sure didn't sign up for. No YouTuber or no social media person or anybody in general deserves to get put through this crap. No one deserves to get put through what I've been put through. And if I can be a voice to help stop it, then I will do whatever I can to help. I will do whatever I can to help to put a stop to this because no one deserves this. And actually, that's not true. That's actually not true, Fed. As I said, when I signed on for social media, I did not sign up to be trolled. I in no way, shape, or form signed on for that kind of harassment. You can ask my friend Matt here in the comments. This man has heard my music. My boy Matt here has heard my music and he's heard what I can do. He's heard what I am capable of doing. And even he can tell you that when I'm not being harassed and I'm not being attacked, I put out some banger fucking tracks. Whether it be an instrumental, a song, a guitar cover, a vocal cover, whatever. This man can tell you firsthand that I actually have skills. And when I'm not being harassed or having to look over my shoulder or having to keep an eye on shit, I'm damn good with what I do. Damn good. Like, I wish I could say that shutting down the computer, shutting down the internet, I wish I could say that that would solve everything, but it won't. And this right, all this shit is why I feel like there needs to be laws against this kind of thing. Like I said, if I can do anything to help push the movement of putting a stop to internet trolling and harassing and gang stalking, if there's anything I can do to push that in the direction of getting all this shit to stop, not just for me, but for people in general, I will do it. I will do whatever I can to help be an advocate for people like myself who get gang stalked, who get harassed, who get bullied, who get entrapped, who get made fun of. I will do whatever I can to help. Because no one deserves to be in that position ever. Oh, trust me, Fred. I'm very well aware of that. Matter of fact, you can ask Matt here in the comments, dude. I've done songs about depression. I've written songs about suicide. I've written songs how I've woken up asking myself, do I really want to live today? Will I make it through today? I've written songs about how I wrestle with my demons. I've written songs about how I go through shit, about how I get attacked, about how I wrestle with all this shit in my head every day and every night. And no, Griker, you will not. Matter of fact, Griker right here is a prime example. Now, let's go right here and let's block you. See, people like this guy named Griker right here, this is what I deal with on a daily basis. He's the kind of people that I deal with. Oh, I'm going to message all your friends and do this. Oh, I'm going to message all your friends and do that. These are the kinds of people that I deal with. The people that think they are so overly confident that they can do whatever they want and get away with it, like the law doesn't apply to them. And as you can tell by Griker's demeanor, like, you can see that he just doesn't care. He has no care. He does not give a shit. And that's how these people operate. This is how trolls and gang stalkers operate. They think that they're above the law, that they're untouchable. But the truth of the matter is, they're not untouchable and they're not above the law. No one is above the law. I don't care how tough you think you are. I don't care how untouchable you think you are. I don't care how badass or smart you think you are. You are not untouchable when it comes to the law. You are not anyone special. No one is above the law. If I have to obey the law, then so do you. As I said, no one deserves to go down this road. No one deserves this kind of garbage. And like I said, this isn't just a U.S. thing. This isn't just a United States thing. This is a worldwide pandemic. Being a troll is essentially a pandemic issue. And when I mean a pandemic issue, I mean it's worldwide. It isn't just one or two people or a small group of people. No, this is a worldwide issue that needs to be taken seriously. That needs to be put to a stop. And as I said, if I can do anything to help the cause, I will do whatever I can to help and put it to a stop. That's awesome, Gar. I'll hit you up in a bit about that. But like I said, this shit, it cannot be taken lightly. This needs to be taken very seriously. Like, yes, I know I've done a lot of shit. I understand that and I accept that. But, as I said, my actions were a result of how the trolls did what they did to me. And like I said, I stand behind Chris Chan because I know that he's not entirely at fault for what he did. These people manipulated him into doing what he did. Is he special needs? Yes. Do I agree with what he did? No. But the fact that these people preyed upon him being a special needs individual is sickening. And people see me and think that I'm special needs, but I'm actually not. I'm just like any other 32-year-old guy. You know? I have a job doing my shit. You know, I have a job just like any other dude. I wake up at 7 a.m. I wake up, take a shower, get dressed, eat breakfast, go to work, come home, do the same shit all over again. I'm just like any other dude. I help to pay bills. I help my family to do shit. I'm just like any other normal guy out there. I'm not this person that people seem to think I am. No, I'm not saying I am special needs. That's not what I'm saying. What I'm saying is that spam risk. What I'm saying is that they see me as special needs. These trolls, they see me as a special needs individual when I'm not. And actually, that's not entirely true, Fed. These people put it in his head. These sick fucks put it in Chris Chan's head that he liked that stuff. They manipulated him to the fullest extent of that. Which ain't cool.
Oh, yeah. Oh! Show me your...
Now, if you'd like to see just how skilled I am... Allow me to show you just what I'm able to do. Give me just 1 second to set up here and I'll show you what I'm capable of doing. Oh, and if, let me just argue with you on one thing here, Fed. If Chris Chan knew what he was doing, then how do you explain that little girl that manipulated him? How do you explain that little girl that manipulated Chris Chan? Who's done it to other people before? Explain that.
Yes.
Now, let me ask you this. Here's the thing. Why is nobody questioning her? See, you can't just have a reaction with no action. For every action, there is a reaction. See, for every cause, there's an effect. For every action, there's a reaction. It's just like alchemy. To obtain something, something of equal value must be lost. That's the law of equivalent exchange. So you can't just have a victim without a perpetrator. You can't have a death without something causing it. You see where I'm going with this? So yes, Chris may have done what he did, but it was out of him being manipulated. Him doing what he did was out of pure manipulation. Pure manipulation. Actually, she kind of did. And besides, how do they know? How do they know there's not more to it? I mean, think about it. How do they not know there's not more to the story? Because I guarantee you, you dig deep enough, you'll find exactly what I'm talking about. Do your research. Dig deep. And I mean, dig fucking deep. The same way I did. I found out a lot of shit, dude. She ain't so fucking innocent. And trust me, I did my fucking research, man. And I can tell you that I stand behind Christian. And I hope that he does do better for himself. Actually, no, they did not. They did not record everything. See, they didn't. See, they don't know their research like I do. See, when I first found out about the Chris Chan shit, I really dug into shit. And trust me when I say, there's a lot of shit that you'll find out that's not recorded. Trust me when I say this, dude. There's a lot of shit that is not recorded, man. A lot of shit that goes unturned, that goes unnoticed. Then I actually started digging up on this chick. And trust me, a lot of people fucking know about it. But if you want to be stupid and not do your research, and follow the sheep, and follow the herd, then by all means, be a sheep, be a herd, be a follower, don't be a leader. I don't care. And dude, why would I need to post the link? Go look for yourself, dude. It's called Do Your Own Research. I mean, you're not disabled. You got two hands. You got fingers. Use them. Why you gotta rely on me to do shit, man? Do it your damn self. You ain't disabled, motherfucker. You got two hands. You know how to type. Do your own goddamn research, dumb fuck. Hell, that's what I did. I did my own research. Ain't nobody had to post the link for me. I did my own research. So you, my friend, need to stop being lazy and do your own research, man. Like, for real, man, do your own research. That's what I did. As a matter of fact, if here's something you can do. Study the videos. Study the people that were involved. Alright? Study the people that were involved with the case. Study that girl that manipulated him. Study the people that attacked him. Do that shit, and I guarantee you, you'll get a whole lot of a different of an outcome than what you're getting. But as I said though, I wanted to make this video to forewarn everybody out there of how these people act, of what these trolls do. And I hope that I was very helpful in some sort of manner to you guys. I really do. I hope and pray to God that I was a help to some of you in some sort of way. And showing you how trolls react. Showing you how trolls do what they do. And I hope that if I can help anyone by even a little bit, then, you know, I'm happy about that. Because like I said, I want this shit to stop just as much as everybody else does. I want to get my life back just as bad as everybody else does. Because no one deserves to live in fear. No one deserves to have their life ruined. No one deserves to be kept from making a living. And as I said, if I can help to put a stop to this crap, I'll do whatever I can. So, if you are actually going through some shit, you know, and you are getting trolled, don't be afraid to reach out to me. Do not be afraid to reach out to me because I want to help people. I want to help real people that have gone through this shit. I want to be somebody that they can rely on as a resource, as a way to help, as, you know, somebody to talk to. Like, I want to be, you know, a part of that fire that puts a stop to all this crap. But with that being said, y'all, I'm about to bounce up off here again. I hope I, you know, was able to inform you guys enough on how these people do what they do and why they do it. And I hope that it helped you guys in some sort of way. I really do. Because no one deserves to live like this. No one deserves to live the way that I've been living for the last 5 years. Like I said, I wouldn't even call what I'm doing living. I'm merely existing at this point. I'm not living. I'm merely existing until this shit gets dealt with. And, you know, when it does get dealt with, trust me when I say, dude, I'm going to be throwing the biggest fucking celebration ever, dude. I promise you that. I can promise you I'll be throwing the biggest fucking celebration ever, dude. Like, that is no joke. I will be throwing the biggest celebration party on stream, on YouTube, on Facebook, ever. Like, I'm going to go fucking ape shit, bro. I'm not even kidding, man. I am going to go fucking ape shit celebrating. Because I want to get my real life back. And I want people to have their lives. You know, like, I don't want, you know, anybody to have to go through what I fucking went through. And thanks, man. I appreciate it. That is actually a Glary guitar with Stratocaster pickups. So it's literally a Glary Strat. And if you don't know what Glary is, it's literally G-L-A-R-R-Y. You can look them up on Google. They've actually got some good guitars. That's what that is. Actually, that's what the amp is as well. It's a Glary Stratocaster guitar. So, I mean, you can look them up. They're actually not that expensive. They're actually really good. But, you know, like I said, you know, if I was some sort of help, I'm glad. If I did something to help somebody or inform you guys, like, you know, I hope that I was informative for you guys. As me being a victim of all this crap and me going through it and me researching it as I'm going through it, you know, I hope that I was able to help somebody out there in some way, like, whether it be, you know, what to watch out for, you know. And as I said, if you're a parent, talk to your kids. Be a part of your kids' lives. Like, talk to your kids about this shit. Get involved. I know they might say, like, oh, you know, and trust me, we've all done it. I've done it. I'm guilty of this. We've all been that kid that's like, oh, no, I don't, blah, blah, blah. Like, you know, the kid wants their space, and I get that. But don't give them that space when it comes to this stuff. Get involved. Do whatever you can to help. And this doesn't just apply to kids. If you have a family member that's going through this shit or a friend, get involved. Don't be silent. Speak up. Say something. Don't just sit there and watch them go through it. Like, speak up and offer any kind of help that you can. Use this video as a reference if you have to. There are plenty of links online where you can go in and look up how to deal with this kind of crap. What, there are no, like, real steps, but, like, it kind of shows you and outlines when you look it up. There's a site that has, like, 130 some odd different types of trolls, and it really outlines the different kind of trolls that there are. Like, it really outlines it, and it's, there's so much information on it that, you know, if you guys do your research, you know, like I said, do like I did. Do your research. Get involved. You know, don't let your friend suffer in silence from being trolled or attacked. And one thing I've had to learn, and I know it sounds stupid, but it's true. Do not ever take any small troll lightly. Do not take any trolling lightly. Because if you do, you're susceptible to attacks. But if you treat it as a very serious thing, then it will be treated seriously. Because like I said, it doesn't just affect your internet life. It can affect your very real life too. And as I said, I am a surviving victim of all this. I can genuinely attest to that and say that this trolling shit doesn't just affect your social media life. This affects and can affect your real life if it is pushed far enough. And I don't want to see anybody go through that. I don't want to see anybody go through what I've gone through for the last 5 years. This has been a 5-long-year battle that's actually finally starting to come to an end for me. And trust me, I am more than excited to get my life back. I am more than excited to finally do what I want to do without being harassed, without being bullied, to be able to build up a community of good people that, you know, support whatever I do, whether that be, you know, gaming videos, whether that be, you know, doing music, whether that be doing the whole VTuber thing that I'm actually delving into slowly. You know, whatever that thing may be, like, I want to be able to build a community of good fucking people that are awesome as shit that support each other. I'm not here to build a community of haters of, oh, you're fucking with that dude, fuck him, oh no, fuck you, no. I want people to be able to get along in my community. I want the supporters that I want to build, I want them to be able to see, like, yo, like, this dude's actually speaking some real shit. Like, this dude actually gets what we're going through. You know, just how Chester was for me, and how guys like Ryan Upchurch are for me. You know, they're real fucking dudes. They speak on real shit. You know, Chester, he spoke on a lot of real stuff that needed to be spoke on, such as depression. And Upchurch, he's that voice for people like myself. He's the voice for the underdogs. He's the voice for the small people. And if I can be that voice for people like myself, then I will be that voice. I will be that voice as much as I fucking can, dude, and I'm not even kidding. I will be that voice as much as I can in any way that I can. But as I said, I hope that this live stream was very informative for you guys, and it gave you guys a very real look into what these people do, and I hope that, you know, it helped you guys in some way. Because, like I said, I was giving you guys a very real look. And I mean a very real look, you know, into what these people do. Is it fun? No. Is it detrimental? Like, can it hurt you? 100% it can. It can ruin your whole life. And no one deserves to go through that. And I mean no one. So as I said, if I can be that voice and help out, I will do whatever I can to help. If you need resources on the different types of trolls, I am more than happy to share any information that I can. Any information I have, I am more than happy to share with you guys. I am more than happy to be like, hey, here's the information I have for this stuff. Here you go. Like, I want to put this stuff to a stop, not just for myself, but for other people. But with that being said, I love you guys. If you guys have any questions, please feel free to hit me up at any time. Like, if you guys want any information about how these trolls work, like I said, you can hit me up. But with that being said, guys, I love you guys. Again, hopefully I was informative, very informative, hopefully. And hopefully you guys now have a better understanding of how these psychopathic individuals work. And yes, I can say psychopathic individuals because that's actually what they are. They are actually psycho. But with that being said, I love you guys, and I hope you guys enjoy the rest of your day, your afternoon, your evening. And, yeah, if you guys need anything, just hit me up. Peace.